Ron Brown. Either boy. Every historical great musical producer in history was born with their very own creative style. This brings us to Ron Browse, a.k.a. Ether Boy. Rondell Edward Turner, better known by his stage name Ron Browse, is an American recording artist, recording producer from Harlem, New York. He initially gained major recognition after producing the Jay-Z diss track Ether by Nas. Due to the popularity of the song, Browns adapted the nickname Ether Boy. Ether Boy. Growing up in Harlem, Browns was just a young, talented man, investing his time into making his dream come true. Spending most of his time in his mother's house, creating music, the Harlem native did not let his lack of equipment stop him from creating historically great beats. Well, at this time, he had no idea they would be historically great. Using a broken keyboard and a broken MPC shows you how determined and destined the young soul really was. The young soul really was. Born December 6, 1982. Wait. Fun fact. At this time of this video, online websites have conflicting information of when he was born. Wikipedia says born on December 6, 1979. And a simple browser search dates him back to December 6, 1982. I guess you can't trace the origins of a god, or should I say a musical phenom.
Ripping up your core next. Blue stones in the watch, call it all Mets. Yeah, I ain't wanna go there, so I took y'all. Got that go yard flow, no football. If L was alive, he would've cooked y'all. With no promoters, my niggas booked y'all.
On every corner in the streets of Harlem, you can find an A-Rap spot. Basically a deli, thrift shop, clothing store, and even a gas station. When Browse got hungry or wanted a cop a fresh new outfit, he would hear this amazing Arabic music playing through the sound system of those establishments. Since he has a musical mind and a great taste for creativity, he remembered those creative and crazy sounds. Storing this information in his mind, he acquired a new way of thinking and building the foundation for his music. See, what you have to understand, there are different levels to this New York hip-hop scene. Let me throw some words out there for you. Beef, gangs, posse, squads, territory. This all plays into who will be king of New York. To be king of New York.
This is hip-hop. We in the Mecca of New York.
The Mecca of hip-hop is like being king of the world. Better yet, known as the GOAT, greatest of all time. New York consists of five boroughs. And in the music industry, you have an artist that brings along his or her team. Or should I say gang, or squad, etc. Each one to hold down their borough and claim that number one spot. History. History. History is undefeated like the internet. History makes us, because without history, we would have nothing. Now think about that for a second. In the movie Gangs of New York, we were introduced to Harlem before the skyscraping buildings and new foreigners who settled on this land. At this time, the fire boroughs were being created. This brought about groups known today as gangs.
Is this it, Priest? The Pope's new army? A few crusty bitches and a handful of ragtags?
I know, Bill. You swore this was a battle between warriors, not a bunch of Miss Nancy's. So warriors is what I brought.
The O'Connell Guard!
The Plogoglies!
The Sharptails!
The Chichesters!
The 40 Thieves!
Bene. On my challenge, by the ancient laws of combat, we are met at this chosen ground to settle for good and all. Who holds sway over the 5 points? Us natives, born rightwise to this fine land. Or the foreign hordes defiling it.
By the ancient laws of combat, I accept the challenge of the so-called natives. You plague our people at every turn. But from this day out, you shall plague us no more. For let it be known that the hand that tries to strike us from this land shall be swiftly cut down.
Then may the Christian Lord guide my hand! Against your Roman popery!
Prepare to receive the true Lord!
Fighting and claiming their very own territory. This is what New York is built on. This is what New York feeds on. New York needs to reign supreme no matter what. But we were fighting for territory. And we dispersed and we separated into our own groups, into our own 5 boroughs. That's so funny. And you take that transition and put it today. You have Queens. You have Staten Island. You have the Bronx. You have Manhattan, which is Harlem. And we cannot forget Brooklyn. You know what I mean? All 5 boroughs is double though. We can't front about that. We have to take that into consideration. York is gangster, you know what I'm saying? But everybody's fighting for that number one spot. So, bring it full circle to the music scene. Nothing has changed. We still grinding. This is how the Ether track evolved. The historically great artist known as Nas from Queens, Nasir Jones, was in one of the many battles to sit at the top of New York and the world. His opponent is no other than legendary Jay-Z from Brooklyn, Mr. Sean Carter. With a quick browser search of these two amazing souls, you can read about their historical great achievements to date. Nas has Ether and countless historic albums. Jay-Z has Takeover and a historic rap sheet that's longer than how many times my father has been arrested. Let me tell you something. Now that is saying something. The beef actually started on the underground mixtape scene. At this time, we were transitioning from tapes to CD. So technology was getting better and hip hop was getting better at the same time. Nas did a freestyle record on DJ Clue Mix CD. Well, we think it was Clue. Can't remember. But still, Nas did a freestyle. It was dope, you know what I'm saying? Here comes Memphis Bleek. Memphis Bleek? Now, what does Memphis Bleek have to do with the story? Well, Memphis Bleek, the legendary hype man for the legendary Jay-Z, founder of Get Low Records, and a rap artist who successfully made 4 albums, with 2 of them topping out at gold. Very successful. After a phone call from a friend to Bleak while he was on vacation in the Bahamas, it was said to him Nas was dissing him. And that was on that freestyle. Immediately, Bleak responded without fact-checking his friend's accusations. This is when Bleak responded with, "Mind Right." If you search on YouTube, you will find two songs, Mind Right and Mind Right Remix. Both songs you should definitely take a listen to. This is when Nas really started getting at the Rock. This is when he first started getting at the Rock, after Mind Right. At this time, Jay-Z had a team, Squad, Rockefeller, I'm saying, Dame Dash, Beanie Siegel, Memphis Bleek, the list goes on. He had a wonderful and excellent team. They were doing it in hip hop. So the big homie, which is known as Jay-Z, said, "I have it from here," and released the Takeover. Just had to take a breath for that one. I'm saying, that was crazy. That was a historic moment for hip hop and the start of a generational movement. Now, I just have to say that again. What a historical moment for hip hop and the start of a generational movement. Back to Harlem.
Yeah. Mommy like, get it pop, used to duck the hitting cops, phones when we hitting spots, I know you see us ops, jealous a girl trait, Rollie's a pearl face, I used to curl weight, to go out to girl place, all night we camping out, no film, the cannon out, on grind, no handing out, dope fiends abandoned house.
All I can say.
This goes out to the mothers, rich or poor. Made sure we had a roof and a floor. Had to bring the change back when I got sent to the store. She needed that back, stepping over crack. No lunch money, they looking at me funny, but I'm glad that she had me. She played a role of daddy too. And the landlord had me aggy too. She never caught me moving baggies, woo. I know it feels like y'all don't get the credit. This is for y'all, if nobody never said it. Made miracles on holidays, now that's epic. Couldn't get me them J's, but that was all accepted. Don't know how you did it, but you did it. Duct tape and windows, it was frigid. Sometimes I can hear my godmother spirit. She wanna let you know she love you, cause you never quit it.
We go with Ron Browse. At this time, at this very same time, the beef was going on between Nas and Jay-Z. Ron Browse was shopping his beats. He was gaining a small buzz and had a manager named Fuzz helping him along the way. On a beat CD laid Ether just sitting there. Might have been track 22 or so. Hip Hop, who was Jay-Z's A&R, came to Ron Browse's mother's house to listen to his beats. Let me say it again. Hip Hop came to Ron Browse's mother's house, and he's Jay-Z's A&R, and he wanted to listen to some beats for either Jay-Z or people in his camp or on that record label. He left the house with two beats. One of them was the Ether beat and another track. Speculation says we don't know if the Ether beat even made it to Jay-Z's desk. So we basically don't even know if Jay-Z even heard the Ether beat. Now that is crazy. So after giving the Ether track to Hip Hop, who was Jay-Z's A&R, they didn't hear nothing for a little while. So Fuzz took the beat CD and asked Nas' travel agent if she could pass along the beat CD to him. Her name is Desiree Herold. Nas hit Browse up months later to let him hear the finished product of the Easter beat. And this was a surprising phone call for Browse because he didn't think Nas was going to use the beat. He didn't even know if Nas actually got the beat CD handed to him. So we all have to thank Desiree Harrell for actually pulling through and giving Nas the beat CD. Because without her, we would never hear the song Ether in the form that it's in today. This was the moment that changed hip-hop forever. Now, since you know the origins of how the song Ether came to be, let's take a closer look into the mind of Ron Browse and Ether. Starting off with a sample of Tupac's voice from the song titled Fuck Friends, Fuck Jay-Z. Rings out. But this is not why the original instrumental was so great. Tupac was later sampled into the finished song. The original beat was created like this. Ron Brown's signature airy sound, mixed with magical strings similar to the ones he heard in the A-Rab spots in Harlem. Browse played the strings as one-shots, or better yet known as stabs. This gives the instrumental a unique approach, storytelling but chaotic at the same time. Using the kick drum as the bass and driving force on the track, his masterful skill set comes in a dynamic range of this orchestrated piece, meaning he is a genius. Two string sounds battling each other in the middle of this mix that I call Jay and Nas. Then a rising string sequence that adds a much needed change and break in a melodic rhythm. Three strings in total. Cymbal crashes that come in with the string rising sequence. This gives the beat a cinematic, edgy feel to it. Now that's nasty, man. I can't tell you how much how that. Oh my God, I can't even talk. That's how nasty that is. The hi-hat is perfectly tucked into the mix, leaving room for the open hat. Now pay attention. Listen. Really, really listen. The open hat is acting as a riser effect for the snare. Listen to that. Listen to the open hat and how it's acting as a small, very small riser effect to bring in the snare hit. Wow. If that doesn't make you a firm believer in musical producers and our abilities to produce, I don't know what to tell you. Ron Browse, a hip-hop icon and legend, will forever be in hip-hop history. You can never talk about hip-hop and not mention Ether Boy.
Fuck Jay-Z.
What's up, niggas? Hey, yo, I know you ain't talking about me, dog. You? What?
Fuck Jay-Z.
You been on my dick, nigga. You love my style, nigga.
Fuck Jay-Z.
Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly.
Lose.
I prove you lost already.
Brace yourself for the main event. Y'all impatiently waiting. It's like an AIDS test. What's the results? Not positive. Who's the best? Pac, Nas, and Big. Ain't no best. East, West, North, South, flaw style greetings. I embrace y'all with napalm. Blows up, no guts, left chest, face gone. How can I be garbage? Send me autos at your cottage. Burner at the side of your dome. Come out of my throne, I got this. Lock since 9-1, I am the truest. Name a rapper that I ain't influenced. Gave y'all chapters, but now I keep my eyes on the Judas. With Hawaiian soapy fame, kept my name in his music. Check it, I
fuck with your soul like ether.
Will.
Teach you the king, you know you.
Nice.
Godson across the belly.
Lose.
I prove you lost already. Ayo, pass me the weed. Put my ashes out on these niggas, man.
No doubt.
Ayo, you faggots, y'all kneel and kiss the motherfucking ring. Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. I've been fucked over, left for dead, distant, forgotten. Luck ran out. They hope that I be gone stiff and rotten. Y'all just piss on me, shit on me, spit on my grave. Talk about me, laugh behind my back, but in my face. Y'all some well wishes, friendly acting, envy, hiding snakes. With your hands out for my money, man, how much can I take when these streets keep calling? Heard it when I was asleep that this Gazy and Cockefeller Records wanted beef. Started cocking up my weapon, slowly loading up this ammo to explode it on a camel and his soldiers. I can handle this Fidolo and his manuscript. Just sounds stupid when KRS already made an album called Blueprint. First, Biggie's your man, then you got the nerve to say that you better than Big. Dick sucking lips, won't you let the late great veteran live?
Will.
Godson across the belly, Luge. I prove you lost already. The king is back, where my crown at? Ill will, rest in peace, let's do it, niggas. Fuck with your soul like ether.
Will.
Teach you the king, you know you. Godson across the belly,
Luge.
I prove you lost already. Y'all niggas deal with emotions like bitches. What's sad is I love you, cause you're my brother. You traded your soul for riches. My child, I've watched you grow up to be famous. And now I smile like a proud dad watching his only son that made it. You seem to be only concerned with dissing women. Were you abused as a child, scared to smile, they called you ugly? Well, life is harsh, hug me, don't reject me. I'll make records to disrespect me, blatant or indirectly. In 88, you was getting chased to your building, calling my crib, and I ain't even give you my numbers. All I did was give you a style for you to run with, smiling in my face, glad to break bread with the guard, wearing jazz chains, no text, no cash, no cars, no jail bars, jigger, no pies, no case, just Hawaiian shirts, hanging with Little Chase. You a fan, a phony, a fake, a pussy, a stan. I still whip your ass. You 36 in a karate class. You Tai Boho, trying to work it out. You trying to get brolic. Ask me if I'm trying to kick knowledge. Nah, I'm trying to kick the shit you need to learn, though. That ether, that shit that make your soul burn slow.
Burn
Is he Dame Diddy, Dame Daddy, or Dame Dummy? Oh, I get it. You Biggie and he's Puffy.
Ew.
Rockefeller died of AIDS. That was the end of his chapter. And that's the guy I chose to name your company after? Put it together. I rock hoes, y'all rock fellas. And now y'all trying to take my spot, fellas? Philly's hot rock, fellas. Put you in a dry spot, fellas. In a pine box with 9 shots for my Glock, fellas. Foxy got you hot cause you kept your face in a puss. What you think, you getting girls now cause of your looks? Negro, please. You know mustache having with whiskers like a rat compared to beans you whack. And your man stabbed on and made you take the blame. You ass went from jazz to hanging with Kane to Irv to Big. And Eminem murdered you on your own shit. You a dick riding faggot. You love the attention. Queens niggas run you niggas. Ask Russell Simmons. Huh. ROC, get gunned up and clap quick. JJ Evans, get gunned up and clap quick. Your whole damn record label, gunned up and clap quick. Sean Carter to Jay-Z, damn you on jazz dick. So Little Shorty's getting gunned up and clap quick. How much of Biggie's rhymes is gonna come out your fat lips? Wanted to be on every last one of my classics. You pop shit, apologize, nigga, just ask Kiss.